Hey everybody, how's it? Aloha. This is Jeeps here, your old composer here at the Decomposer Lounge, World Music. I want to thank you for hanging out. As I move forward in this channel, I've come to find that I've got quite a few artists with a very big fan base that keeps, you know, asking me to come back, and I'm going to. If anybody knows me from my other channel, my heavy metal rock and roll channel, what I might do is a few weeks of new artists and acts and stuff like that, and then I eventually circle back. So yes, I am going to come back to a lot of the music I've done in the past. But for right now, one of the new artists that I'd like to spend a little time with, remember, I'm going to get the names wrong. I appreciate your patience and maybe helping me learn how to say the name, but Loic Notier, that's as good as I'm going to get. I'm not going to try anymore. And the song is called Million Eyes. Okay, so I want to thank you very much for hanging out. I want to thank you so much for those of you who have shared my videos, those of you who have subscribed, those of you who are hanging in there waiting for me to get back to your favorite artist or band. I promise I will be getting back. All right, let's do this. Loic Notier, if that's the right way to say it, Million Eyes. All right. Beautiful voice. What a powerful voice. And able to pull off, very first time I'm hearing this young artist, and able to pull off already a series of dynamics in the tone of his voice. I don't do a theoretical breakdown. This is your first time, you know, hanging out with me. So I kind of peel back the layers without over demystifying the song, but try to maybe bring light to a couple things. When I say the term dynamics on this channel, I talk about the kind of things that musicians, and a vocalist to me is also a musician because this is their instrument, that they can do with their voice or their guitar or their bass or their drums in order to take what you might think is a basic note. Let's just say he's singing, but he may do something to kind of give it an edge at the end, or change the shape of his mouth to give it a particular sound, even though he's holding the note out, it's a consistent note. If he changes the shape of his mouth or something in here, and it flexes that note, that's called a dynamic. In orchestral work, dynamics is a little bit different. It's like when you're reading music, orchestral music, that dynamic will tell you to play louder and then come down, and then there's different markings in score music that help the person who's playing the instrument along with a conductor. Okay, all that being said, let me talk just briefly about the music. Obviously, everything so far is synth-oriented, but here's what I love. There's one instrument that's kind of following his set melody. Da, 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 da. And it just slightly, it's in the background, it repeats itself, but there's another piano, there's like a keyboard or piano patch that is just playing two chords. But what's killer about that, especially if you have headsets, it has kind of a vibe tremolo to it. So you kind of, in tempo to the song, you can hear the swimming of that. And remember, that's what my dissections are all about, are we already celebrate the power of the vocalists You know, obviously they are the front of everything. They are the artist, but it's the work that goes behind it to support it. And every one of these artists, I think, might agree with me that is such an important part of what it is their end art delivered to us means across the board. You know, is that, you know, that kind of production, that kind of composition, as simple and easy. Remember, simple is not easy. Wrap your head around that one. It's to choose those right movements and sounds in order to lift or support a performance like this. And then finally, before I go on, I noticed in the video that he's an incredible expressionist, art, dancing and stuff. To me, when I see an artist that is this talented with this kind of expression of dance and stuff like that, there are probably many other super hidden talents within this artist that are yet to come, that we get to see as he, you know, matures, you know, through his years and stuff. But this dual expression of being able to sing and being able to act and being able, or you know, present, perform, and especially at this level, this is fantabulous. All right, let's keep going a little. I'm sorry for stopping there. I'm just gonna say something short here. That beautiful thing he does with the tone of his voice, you can see where I'm reacting. I can't remember because I don't listen to the lyrics, and especially if I don't know the language or whatever, but obviously he does that thing where it's almost like an abyss sound. You know what I'm talking about. I don't know how to explain what I'm hearing, but it's just absolutely wonderful. I've never heard it before. I've never heard something like that before. It's unbelievable. Also, the build in the hook in this chorus, what we just heard is what's considered the hook or the chorus of the song, because it's a very memorable melody. I can't, da, da, da. If I tried to do it in the upper voice, I go, bo, bo, I'd sound correct, but da, 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 da. Very memorable hook, but then the support behind it, you know, grows exponentially because now he's fully powered into this, so you want the support of the composition and the arrangements and back to lift. Doesn't mean that there's necessarily more instruments added to it. It's just maybe a flipping of the arrangement from one instrument to another. Remember I said there was one instrument that sounded like it was a melody at the beginning, another one was a soft keyboard. Well, it sounded like the melody keyboard took up a little more power. This one still kept playing. Percussion got a little more beefier. And then there was background. There was some background going on there and a little bit of, if I can remember if it was pad work, but it lifts and supports. So right now at this point of the song, in what I would consider pop structure, song construction, we're probably going to go into a bridge or a turnaround or some kind of breakdown of sorts, and then we'll probably go into a chorus out. So I'm not going to stop this video anymore. We're going to listen together, and then I'll have my final thoughts.
talk behind my back, you spy on me. So I scream and shout to make you leave, but you still here.
You know, one of the things that I was mentioning early on was the fact that, you know, when the hook came in, that I heard like a pad. It was kind of a string pad, so it's supposed to emulate strings. It could be real strings. My hearing senses, it sounds more like a string pad or a sampled string pad that's going on in the back and stuff. And you know, what that does is that gives that kind of props open and gives you this kind of universal ambient vibe to the track. I mean, his voice has a really wonderful long cathedral or church style reverb on it and everything. They already give us that long, like in a tunnel kind of feeling here. I didn't listen to the words. As you know, I don't listen to the words on the first listen. I know some people go, how do you do that? It's because I'm a composer breaking down more of the music and explaining the elements the way I do. I think one of the things I do on my other channel, and I've just started doing, is going back to tracks that I've, you know, already dissected, and then I'll just do a lyric review. You know, so perhaps I'll do that on some of your bands as well, or artists. One other thing I want to say about the tone of his voice, I just got through doing, on my other channel, a very well-known punk rock kind of alternative band, called Coheed and Cambria, and his voice has that phenomenal high pitch with power to it, and it's much like the Geddy Lee from Rush or Dimash. Each one of those artists have different capabilities with their voice, like the gentleman Dimash has what, 7 or 8 octave range. It's a very unique thing that we as the listening audience get really caught up with how high vocalists can go. Some of them it's just because it's the pitch of their voice. And sometimes we lose sight of how powerful and how wonderful their melodies are sometimes, because we're just so blown away by the, God, did they hit that note? But hitting that note in a series of notes that fulfill a complete melody too, sometimes gets slightly gets pushed to the side a little bit because we're just so excited that I can't believe they hit that note. That kind of thing that does happen sometimes, not for me and maybe not for you, it doesn't take away from the song, but all of a sudden you just get blown away by the actual ability of the artist more than the song that they're singing. You know, that's not bad or good. I'm just bringing that up as a point and stuff. So anyhow, thank you so much for hanging out. This was a wonderful experience. I didn't do any research, so can you guys maybe tell me where he's from and if there's any other songs or tracks of his you'd like for me to do? And thanks for hanging in there. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for supporting the channel. And starting next week, I'm going to cycle back through all of the comments and all of the suggestions you guys have been giving me about the artists and the bands and, you know, the K-pop, E-pop, Pinoy pop, I guess it's called. There's so many things that I'm learning. I don't know. I'm just learning. I'm going to start going back and revisiting those with new tracks. So that'll be fun for some of you who've been waiting a while for me to do that. All right, guys, you take care of yourself. Have a wonderful day. Aloha.